I often say, I want this or that. I am happy or unhappy. The first thought that comes to me is I. But did I understand that I? Who am I really? It is stated that everything is predestined. So is my meeting with Rupa and Surendra in Bengaluru on 25th March. Paul Brunton's book, A Search in Secret India, has introduced me to the teachings of Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi for the first time. I liked it very much, especially the concept of who am I. By coincidence, I also happened to see a movie titled Granny in YouTube made on Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. Deeply inspired, I decided to visit Tiruvannamalai for 3 days. Did you notice how many times the word I has been used? That I is my ego slash pride. That I makes me stand apart from others. That I fills me with desires and makes me run for worldly pleasures. That I leads me to sorrow slash frustration. That I makes me angry, sad, happy, cunning, afraid, wicked, etc. Finally, that I makes me question my existence. Who am I really if I am not that individual slash ego? Do not worry, the question will be answered shortly. Meanwhile, you just enjoy the video. Let us first see the highlights of my trip to Tiruvannamalai. Visiting Ramanashramam and spending time meditating there is one of the nicest experiences you can have in Tiruvannamalai. A visit to Lord Arunachaleswar temple will soak you in devotion and makes you awe for the grand architecture of that temple. Doing Giripradakshana around the sacred Arunachala mountain makes you humble and makes you realize your potential. Do not miss visiting Skandashramam and Virupaksha cave. Let's move on to Arunachaleswar temple. Lord Shiva is known by devotees as Annamalayar or Arunachaleswarar. This is believed to be the largest temple dedicated to Lord Shiva. The history of this temple dates back to thousands of years. I am fortunate to have his darshan twice during my stay in Tiruvannamalai. There is a Puranic story about the origin of the hill. Once Vishnu and Brahma fell to disputing which of them was the greater. Their quarrel brought chaos on earth, so the Devas approached Shiva and besought him to settle the dispute. Shiva thereupon manifested himself as a column of light from which a voice issued declaring that whoever could find its upper or lower end was the greater. Vishnu took the form of a boar and burrowed down into the earth to find the base, while Brahma took the form of a swan and soared upwards to seek its summit. Vishnu failed to reach the base of the column, but beginning to see within himself the supreme light which dwells in the hearts of all, he became lost in meditation, oblivious to the physical body, and even unaware of himself, the one who sought. Brahma saw the flower of an alce plant falling through the air and thinking to win by deception, returned with it and declared he had plucked it from the summit. Vishnu admitted his failure and turned to the Lord in praise and prayer. You are self-knowledge, you are Om, you are the beginning and the middle and the end of everything. You are everything and illuminate everything. He was pronounced great while Brahma was exposed and confessed his fault. In this legend, Vishnu represents the intellect and Brahma the ego, while Shiva is Atma, the spirit. The story continues that because the lingam or column of light was too dazzling to behold, Shiva manifested himself instead as the Arunachala hill, declaring, as the moon derives its light from the sun, so other holy places shall derive their sanctity from Arunachala. This is the only place where I have taken this form for the benefit of those who wish to worship me and obtain illumination. Arunachala is Om itself. Let us surrender our intellect and ego to Lord Arunachala. Now let's come back to the question of who am I. You are watching this video on your screen currently. Various scenes are being projected on your screen. The video is temporary, but the screen is permanent and the screen is not affected by the various scenes projected on it. And you are not aware of the screen when a video is being shown. Now think about this. Your mind is projecting various scenes of the world onto a screen. You are unable to recognize the screen since various scenes are being played continuously. Suppose your mind stops projecting. Then you will see the screen only. That screen is called Self or Brahman or Atman. It alone exists and is permanent in nature. The world appears when the mind projects externally. In deep sleep, there is no world because the mind is not projecting. The nature of that Self is eternal, pure consciousness and bliss. Remember that we are that Self already. We will come back to the topic of Self shortly. I met this monkey on my way to Skandashrama. It grabbed my water bottle and tried to drink it. I wanted to help, but I am helpless. Poor monkey could not drink the water and I left him to his fate. Hoping that God will take care of him, let's move on to Skandashramam and Virupaksha cave. For reaching Skandashramam and Virupaksha cave, we have to walk 1.4 kilometers on the hill. I just want to mention that Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi lived in Skandashramam and Virupaksha cave before moving to Ramanashramam. The rest of the details can be obtained from the website. I recommend you to do meditation at least for 10 minutes at these two places. These monkeys go through their daily routine without making a fuss. Maybe we shall learn from them. The trek to these ashrams is slightly tedious and needs to be done carefully since it involves walking on the stones most of the time. It is definitely worth taking that effort since it offers you a different kind of experience. Sri Ramana Maharshi stayed at various places in Tiruvannamalai and then in several caves on the Arunachala hill
until he finally settled at what came to be called Sri Ramanashramam, where he lived until his Mahanirvana in April 1950.
While enjoying these views, let's go back to the topic of I am that self. Let's see what happens when I am that self. There is no you, I and others. There is nothing to desire. There is nothing to gain / lose. There is nothing that belongs to us. There is nothing to compare with. There is no pleasure / sorrow. There is nothing to be afraid of. There will be no duality. A lasting peace that is eternal in nature will descend on us.
We will continue with this topic of lasting peace in a while. Meanwhile, let's do Giri Pradakshina. Walking around the hill with bare foot is called Giri Pradakshina. The total distance to be covered is 14 kilometers. Bhagavan gave the following reply when a devotee questioned the importance of doing the Giri Pradakshina. For everybody, it is good to make circuit of the hill. It does not even matter whether one has faith in this Pradakshina or not. Just as fire will burn all who touch it, whether they believe it will or not, so the hill will do good to all those who go round it. Once he said to a devotee, "Why are you so concerned with all these questions about the efficacy of going round the hill? Whatever else you may or may not get, you will at least have the benefit of the physical exercise. Let's walk into the Ramanashramam now. As you enter the ashram, you will find the bookstall and the office on the right side. You will first find Matru Bhuteshwara temple on the left side, followed by the Samadhi hall. The ashram follows a daily schedule and it performs various rituals. You can do meditation at the meditation hall, or alternately you can do the meditation at the Matru Bhuteshwara temple or at the Samadhi hall. On the first day, I did a quick tour of ashram and the first thought that came is, what am I going to do for 3 days? There doesn't seem to do much even in one day. Then I heard a lecture being given there and the topic was self-surrender. It struck me instantly that why am I worrying? It is God who brought me here and He will decide or make me do whatever He wants. I will simply leave this to Him. With that, my anxiety stopped. This is the place where we will get lasting peace, as we were discussing earlier. The lasting peace can be obtained by practicing the direct method of self-inquiry prescribed by Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. I suggest you to download and read a free short book called Who Am I from the Ramanashramam website. After that, you read teachings of Sri Ramana Maharshi in his own words.
Before we go, let's summarize the key points. The key points that we discussed are, I am not an individual or ego. I am the self which is eternal, pure consciousness and bliss. I shall practice the path of self-inquiry prescribed by Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. That will lead me to lasting peace.
Thank you for watching the video. Please do feel free to talk to me if you need to discuss more about this topic.